Hey guys, today I will explain the basic concept of a control system and where we use these concepts. So I'll start with a very common example which we use in our daily life. An air conditioner is a system which maintains a desired temperature in a closed room or closed area. And the purpose of it is to maintain the temperature of that closed area, which is set by the user. So now we will see how it works. At the heart of the air conditioner, we have a cooling system, which can bring the temperature low compared to the ambient temperature. It is actually a compressor which blows cold air into the room. Now, if we keep the cooling system on continuously, then the room temperature is set by the cooling system and the ambient temperature. And at some point, it comes into equilibrium and then temperature remains there. But that is a function of the cooling system's performance as well as what is the temperature, what is the ambient temperature. So you do not have any control. And that's not the air conditioner used for. So now what we do is that there is a temperature sensor built into the air conditioner which measures the ambient temperature and gives a signal in terms of voltage. Now that voltage is the representation of the temperature, gets compared with the reference input. The reference input also is a voltage which comes from a different system. So you set the temperature through the remote control, which is a number, and then that number gets converted to voltage. All those things are pretty easy to do in today's electronics. So, but you have the system which converts the number to a voltage. Now that reference voltage gets compared with the temperature sensor's output, and this error amplifier amplifies that small error and makes a decision whether the cooling system should be on or off. Now how it works? You turn on the cooling system and let's say you start with a temperature which is 40 degree. Ambient temperature and room temperature is 40 degree to start with. Now your cooling system is on. It keeps blowing cold air and then temperature keeps dropping. And let's say you have set the temperature at 20 degree or 22 degree. So it is the temperature, room temperature keeps going down. Temperature sensor tracks it and continuously gives the voltage output. The moment it go below 22 degree centigrade, error amplifier makes a decision, okay, I should not keep this on anymore because I have reached the desired temperature. I can keep it off for some time. Now it shuts down the cooling system. And then temperature again starts rising up because ambient temperature is 40 degree. So it is getting hotter and hotter. And the moment it goes beyond 22 degree centigrade, the reference, the error amplifier makes again another decision. Okay, temperature has gone up to 22 degree centigrade. I should switch on the cooling system again. And then this error amplifier, like this, the error amplifier makes a runtime decision whether the cooling system should be on or off. Okay. And then temperature output temperature or the ambient temperature is fluctuating around the desired temperature. So it is maintained with a small band of around the desired temperature. Now we can clearly see that this entire air conditioner system has three different purposes. The main purpose is to cool down the temperature, air temperature or ambient temperature. But on top of that, you have a monitoring mechanism, a temperature sensor, which is continuously monitoring the room temperature. And the third component is comparing the room temperature with respect to a reference input and making a decision. So these are the three distinct function within the control system. And if I write them in control system terminology, the first one is called actuator, which is the main system to be controlled and which does the fundamental purpose. In this case, the cooling is done by this actuator. The second function is a feedback, which is like keeping an eye on the output. And third component is a controller, error amplifier, which makes a runtime decision to instruct the actuator. And these three component, three function distinctly makes a control system. Okay. Now I'll summarize this in this diagram. So any control system has three component: actuator, feedback, and error amplifier. Now we will see what actually we get from this control system. We already said that it gives a more accurate and desired output. In this case, the temperature is tightly maintained around the desired set temperature, which is 22 degrees centigrade. The second thing is the output is less sensitive to the external disturbance. That means the room temperature is independent of the atmospheric condition, whether it is 40 degree outside the room or minus 10 degree outside the room. Air conditioner should maintain the temperature which is set by the user. And the same machine works in different region on the earth. That means whether it is polar region, means which is winter dominated area, polar region, or the tropical area like India, it does not matter. You set the temperature, it will try to maintain within that closed room. And the third thing is, it is less dependent on any individual component. What it means is that the room temperature is not dependent on how quickly the cooling system reacts or what is the cooling rate of the cooling system. It does not matter. Finally, it settles to the desired output. So it is less sensitive to the individual component, and it gives it less sensitive to the ambience condition. It is more accurate around the for the desired output. These are the three main advantages of a control system. Now, does it mean that it is unconditionally it will work like this? No, everything has certain limit, and the designer who decides the control system components and makes it has to take a proper decision and take care of that conditional things where it works. Okay. Now we will see where it is used. Actually, in modern day, that same philosophy is being used everywhere in your life. In economics, you can take the example of the inflation control system. The moment inflation goes high, our government takes some regulatory steps and then it comes down. Okay, you can split it into three components. Inflation is going high, government has a regulatory body, they keep on high. Keep an eye on it and then take some decision, which is the control system, and then it goes down. Medical, automatic dose control of drugs and anesthesia. A professional know what is the drug to be used for what cause, but what is the dose of it, that has to be decided based on individual conditions, and that can be done in automatic ways. You can feed the reports, age and inputs, and then based on that it takes the decision. You don't need that particular doctor every time. In engineering field, almost everywhere around you, I have taken the example of the air conditioner, but anything in the around you is controlled with these basic three steps. Okay, so I guess it is clear what is the control system, what is the main building blocks, and where do you need it. In the subsequent videos, I'll explain the main further more details on the main concepts, where it works and how design. So keep following us on our site. Bye bye.